So when I'm looking for fish, smaller fish, like that was a question on TW, you're like, how do you find smaller eater schools of fish? So I classify that as, you know, like a 20 inch, 19 inch and under. And here's a good way to do it. 2 miles an hour and under, you know, like right here, these are fish right there. That's a fish. And how I know that is I can simply cursor over to that and blow it up. And look at that. Those are fish. 1, 2, 3. This fish may be facing towards me a little bit because this returns a little longer. That one's a little longer. But that's it. You slow down. Like right now I'm going 0.9. So your return on larger fish, your beam's going to be able to peg that fish multiple times. On smaller fish, it's only going to be able to hit it so many times. So that's why instead of messing with settings, I just slow down the boat a little bit and start marking the fish. If you look here, here's a couple more. And these fish are not casting a shadow. There's a fish. They're not casting a shadow. There's another one on this side of the boat. That tells me that those fish are tighter to the bottom. Now, when a fish casts a shadow, it means it's higher off the bottom. That's how I find fish on there. And you may see these little, you know, brighter colors and you're like, well, I wasn't sure that was a fish. Those are fish. That's part of being confident in your electronics. So when you're looking for eater schools, guys, slow down your speed. I only look in a 50 foot window. So 50 feet that way, 50 feet this way. So port starboard 50 feet. Now I'm gonna show you when I go into my settings, the reason I have it set at 40 or 50 feet. If I go into my settings and I go out to 70 or 80 feet, I can still see fish in there, right? But my image is a lot longer and I'm targeting an area. Right now I wanna know how many fish are actually in, you know, this shallow flat area I'm in. Right there I got below, you know, half mile an hour. Now I'm picking back up and it elongated the images again. So when I speed up, you see how my screen got a little clearer? And again, fish, fish, fish. That one there is actually casting a little bit of a shadow. You can kind of see behind them. So then I go in, blow up that image, and it's like, oh, there you go. You know, a little bit of a shadow there. That tells me that fish is a little bit farther off the bottom. Stuff like this here, that's a scraggly little stick down there. You don't want to be running your bottom bouncers through that. Guaranteed, that's a guaranteed snag right there. But by utilizing your feet out, like when I'm looking for bigger fish, like here's a bunch of smaller fish in a school right here. They're all peppered all over. So I shrink down my viewable area, you know, down to, I'd say 40, 50 feet. And that really lets me blow up my images. It tells me where in the area I'm searching instead of dissecting it by 100 foot sections and kind of going, are those small walleyes in there or aren't those small walleyes? By doing, like here you go, here's a perfect example right here of a fish off the bottom. Right there, fish off the bottom. And if you need to, I don't need to, but you can blow it up and go, okay, fish, shadow. That fish is 1.5, 2 feet off the bottom, casting a shadow. I know that one's an active fish. We've all seen those mega imaging images of tuna and sturgeon where you can kind of, you can see the outline of the fish and it's really cool. You're not gonna get that when you're looking for eater fish walleye. You're gonna get stuff like this right here, 1, 2, 3, 4 blips on the screen. And basically that's it. Like I have killer images of muskies and things like that, sturgeon on my mega imaging. But for smaller fish, you're gonna wanna look for these little deals here. Now, here's a good example of a fish, awesome, that the timing's awesome. Right here, here's a fish off the bottom casting a shadow. Here's a fish, maybe two fish, that are tight to the bottom and not casting a shadow. And I'm actually gonna go over there and blow that up just to show you, because this is a really, really good point to make right now. So right there, this fish is off the bottom, probably 1.5, 2 feet, casting a shadow. I know that fish is up. Here's one, possibly two fish right there that are tight to the bottom, maybe laying there dormant or just, you know, within a couple inches of the bottom. So that's what you're looking for. That doesn't mean that there's only one fish. There's 2 to 3 fish right there. That one is up and that one's feeding. So those last three fish, those were 12 to 18 inch fish. And that's the profile of the fish. About that tall, maybe that tall at the biggest for an 18 inch fish that's not gonna cast that much of a shadow unless it's farther off the bottom. Now you get into your 23, 24, 26, 27, bigger walleyes. Those, even when they're on the bottom, still might cast a little bit of a shadow. Now when they're up higher, they're going to cast a bigger shadow. I've actually seen outlines of larger walleyes on there, so keep that in mind when you're looking for bigger schools of walleye. You're not looking for these little blips. You're looking more for that thing that looks like a grain of rice when it's right on the bottom and brighter on your screen. So now, other thing that goes with that is I actually will elongate, you know, 70, 80, 90 feet on either side when I'm looking for those bigger images, because it's, you know, relative to the size of the screen. So I can, my field of view gets bigger because I'm looking for bigger fish. Smaller fish, I shrink it down a little bit and go the same route. So play with your side imaging, get her dialed in, and be confident in what you're looking at. And I challenge anyone, when you think you see a group of five or six fish and you think they might be crappies and they may be 3-4 feet down, spin the boat around, spot lock it 20 feet away, chuck a bobber or jig or whatever you want, and catch those fish. And that's how you really get good with side imaging, is translating what you're seeing on your screen and going back and hooking them in the mouth. And that just tells you exactly that you're doing everything right. And again, not to beat it up, there's a lot of fish here, but right there, see that image? That's a fish right there that we just went over on the side imaging. And I'm not gonna speak for Brett, but we've been doing this piece for like 5 minutes and we went over a ton of fish, so I think we should probably start fishing these now instead of looking at them. So, but that's it. I hope it helps you guys. Bigger fish, smaller fish. Watch this video again and kind of see my settings on there and drive over them and be confident with what your side imaging is telling you, because the days of sonar lying and making things up and is that a fish, is that not a fish, they're gone. We can actually see pictures of the bottom now that are literally like you're looking at it with your own two eyes.